This is Junior. Junior, as you can see, is extremely matted all over from head to toe. So we're gonna have to shave him. I'm gonna try it with a number 10. Junior's also prone to biting. So we'll see how this goes. So what I'm doing now is any part that is drippy like this that can cause the skin to do that, that part of the skin can get easily nicked the next time I go past it with my clippers. So I'm just trying to get any little drippy parts off. I don't know if you can, let's look over here. Here's a good example of it. All this stuff, how it buckles the skin. And that's how the dogs get nicked so easily. All right, so I actually have a fan that's blowing on my other number 10s, trying to keep them cool while I try to get this off of him. It's the only way I can keep going. Otherwise, it's just, I'd have to stop and let them cool off in between. Okay, stay. His nails are like cat nails. They're razor sharp. It's already scratched me up really good, so I'm gonna try to get rid of those before I go any further. Super sharp, like just like a cat. Nope, don't do that. You always have to keep an eye on your dog. If he tries to get the muzzle off with his paws like that, he could scratch and damage his eye. So there's very rare times where I have to put a muzzle on a dog to finish their groom. But if they also are fighting trying to get off this muzzle, and I need them to be muzzled, then I can't groom them at all, because then they'll go home with eye injuries, you know, just trying to get that off. Junior's had his bath, he's all clean. Now we're gonna put on the finishing touches so he can finally go home. Right, buddy? Okay, stay. Good boy. Totally different dog than what he started off with. You can actually see his little face. Back in business. Okay, we'll see you next time. You be good boy. I know you did really good. Really good. Okay, we say goodbye to everybody.